Hello, everyone, and welcome back to theCUBE's coverage of the HIMSS Conference 2025 here at the Venetian in Las Vegas. I'm your host, Rebecca Knight. We're here with Google and many of its ecosystem partners talking about the future of healthcare innovation and the future of agentic AI. With that, I've got two great guests for this next segment. I would like to welcome Shweta Maniar. She is the Director of Strategic Industries, Healthcare, and Life Sciences at Google. Thank you so much for coming on
the show, Shweta.
And Ron Rerko, he is Practice Director, Healthcare and Life Science at Onix. Thank you so much for coming on the show, Ron. Ron, I want to start with you. Why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about Onix, what you do, what you're all about?
All right, thank you. So Onix is a 30-year-old company. We've been around for, three decades now. We were the first partner with Google back in like 2003. We have gone global in the last 3 years, so we're all over the, Europe, United States, Canada, India, Asia, all over. And we've put a strong focus this year on our healthcare division, which I'm part of trying to come at it, solve healthcare problems for the physicians, for the nurses, for the hospitals, and for biotech and all the others, pharma insurers. So, been around for a while doing great work with about 1,500 people across the world.
And solving healthcare problems too. So, let's set the scene first. We're going to be talking about an Expanse tool that that Onix recently launched. Why don't you tell our viewers a little bit about the clinical challenges that healthcare providers face when working with electronic medical records?
So I think all of us understand this because we've all seen our doctors. We're tired of the doctors staring at a screen when they should be looking at us and trying to collate the information from us and understand our body language and so forth. They're also overwhelmed with the amount of work they have to do. They're spending a third of their day on administrative tasks. So then that's limiting the amount of time that they can actually spend with the patient. Then they're trying to review an electronic medical record, which they're all very good systems, but recognize that the data could be disparate, it could be in different data systems. So then they have to become almost like a technology person to correlate all these different things across the system. And how do we look at someone, of a little older age, of my records going for decades? How would you actually go through that record in the 3 to 5 minutes that you have before you walk into the patient's office? And what I've been seeing and hearing from the physician friends I have, they're spending maybe 3 to 5 minutes reviewing a record before they go in to see the patient. How do you look at 3 to 5 minutes of 3 decades of work and actually come up with something? So the problem is huge. And one of the doctors I recently spoke with said, if you can just give me 40 seconds per patient a day, I will love you forever. So they come to me saying, give me technology solutions that enable me to see the patient, talk with the patient, and really provide the best data back to them and the best information to the patient for their care. Help me do that. Help me pull the EMR out and find the highlights of that patient and what they need and how I can personalize it for that patient.
So Shweta, Ron has just painted a vivid picture of physicians who are drowning in admin. Do you have anything else you would add about the efficiency or lack thereof in terms of the workflow of these healthcare teams?
Yeah, absolutely. Like Ron said, right, one third of the time is being spent on administrative tasks. But one of the aspects is that they're trying to put together unstructured and structured information, right? And they're trying to create these efficiencies across a variety of, if it's images, if it's structured data, if it's written notes. And so a lot of that time that we're seeing, or the inefficiencies that we're seeing in the workflow, is actually around getting that information in a manner that you can have a longitudinal understanding of a patient's journey, as opposed to actually going in and caring for the patients, as you had mentioned. So part of the way that we're seeing these kind of solutions and tools have a role in the workplace for hospital systems and clinics is around being able to provide these type of efficiencies so that we can let doctors be doctors and caregivers be caregivers.
So these are the kinds of challenges that you were seeking to address with this search, with this Expanse tool. Tell our viewers a little bit about it and the impetus for it.
Right. So again, recognize that when we're talking about healthcare, this is why it really is a mission for me. We're talking about everybody. So how do we help everybody with technology? So what this search and summarization tool does is it can go through the EHR, crawl through it, and other records, bring it together and summarize it into an executive summary, to put it as simply as possible, for the physician to look at and say, what are the most important points I need to know about this patient? Did they describe something 10 years ago that I need to focus on? So how do we take all that information, digest it down, and remember, which is something I always highlight, it's clinical decision support. It's coming back to the physicians as, we're supporting your efforts. You're the ones that are making the decisions. You're the ones making all the diagnoses. This is merely trying to pull the information together so you can make the best diagnosis that you can.
And how does natural language processing and large language models improve the extraction and presentation of the data?
So you've got that. You've also got MedPalm and things like that involved with these large language models, is understanding the words and the context. So being able to understand the context. If I go into a record and say, is the patient blue? It has to understand that word, because blue could mean, do they have oxygen problems or are they depressed? As we would do as humans, we'd focus on that. So now it's able to define the context of the word to provide it back faster. So if you're just doing a mere search in a way, without the AI capabilities that we can overlay on this, you're going to get potentially not full answers that you want. This is now taking it to the next level where it's actually interpreting the context so that I, as a physician, I don't have to become a prompt engineer. I can just start asking questions and it understands what I'm trying to do from a medical model and provides those type of answers back to me.
And now, trust is obviously so critical in any kind of healthcare delivery. How does this tool ensure security and privacy of patient data while maintaining all of the things that it needs to do in order to get to the right diagnosis and questions?
Absolutely, right? So everything that we're doing from a Google Cloud perspective and with our partners, right, holds the utmost, the highest level of scrutiny where it comes to our security and privacy, supporting organizations with their HIPAA compliance. Partners, again, like Onix, continue to enhance that as well, if you want to also add a couple of points there around the privacy and security aspect.
Yeah, we're constantly, even in the background, looking at data governance and AI governance and trying to develop that, because what we're seeing currently in the industry is sort of what you're seeing, the tip of the iceberg. There's so much going on behind that, where we're working with partners and working directly with Google to make sure that we're preparing this for the next phase of what it'll be. What are we going to have to see in the next year or two with this addition of AI and all the other tools that we're starting to bring in?
I also want to add that as you're looking at trust in these systems, you don't have to be a coder or a technical expert, to be able to use these tools. And I think that's a big part of actually leveraging these tools in a scalable way, is if you want caregivers, for example, to use these tools, it needs to be understandable for them. It needs to be trustworthy for them. And so we are committed to a lot of the explainability and the transparency, so that you can, if you are a caregiver or a doctor, you can then trust in the systems that the outputs of these summarizations or the way that you're searching is actually complete and holistic in the way that you're expecting it to be.
Well, from a patient perspective, I can certainly see its efficacy, because there are things that may be in your medical history that you've forgotten about, that you don't remember. Oh, right, I did have a surgery on that knee 20 years ago that could be affecting how my joint is working now. Can you talk a little, Ron, about some specific outcomes or improvements that healthcare providers have seen since implementing this tool?
So a lot of times we can look at, not only like you said, of just summarizing important information, but starting to look for clues within the electronic medical record, which is a huge clinical database of a lot of information. What else can we pull out of that? I'm from medical genetics and did a lot of work in that, understanding that the lifetime risk of a female in the United States is about 12% for breast cancer. So what do you have to look for in the medical records of finding out, is there cancer running in the family? If so, that risk can go up to 40, 50, or even higher percent, which then indicates we now need to start looking at that as far as more imaging, more diagnostics and that. So it's starting to move to that next level of, how do we do data-enabled healthcare? We've done it for many years, I would say centuries, of more the art of medicine, and we've had phenomenal physicians who are practicing this. We're starting to move into this phase of the science of medicine. And how do we start pulling this data together in a structured way, as Shweta said, in order for us to present it to the physicians.
Well, Ron just hinted at this, but besides physicians, what other stakeholders do you see as potentially benefiting from this tool? I'm thinking about geneticists, infection control teams. How do you see them utilizing this?
You know, there's applications across the entire ecosystem, right? Not just within a healthcare system or a hospital, but really across the entire health ecosystem. If you're thinking about the payers and the providers and the researchers and those sitting in, looking at the next best, you know, treatments and medicines and such. But really, if you want to just look at it in the context of the healthcare ecosystem, there could be things that are looking at not just the caregivers, genetic counselors, those who are researching clinical trials, right? Those who are recruiting for clinical trials, those who are looking at additional use cases or additional ways to take care of patients based on their history. So there's a lot of, I would say, across the entire board within a healthcare system, there is some way that you can take advantage of these type of tools moving forward.
Ron, what are your plans for implementing this AI search and summarization tool in additional healthcare providers?
So we're working very closely with our partner Meditech and Google in looking at the other hospital systems that Meditech has their EHR already implemented in and trying to roll it out into those institutions too. Because we find it, as Onix as a company, as we can support this, we're, again, support system helping Google and Meditech to take this out into the industry. And I think that's a key factor. It's not like we're trying to take it out as a very strong technology company of taking it out into the industry. We're working with partners and saying, how do you best implement this into a system? So you work with the partners who are already involved in the systems, and we're already looking at several hospital systems to expand this out into.
So you started our conversation by talking about conversations that you'd had with doctors saying, what are you up against? What can we help you with? And one doctor you said, give me 40 seconds more with my patients. In your wildest dreams, if Expanse is as successful as you hope it will be, what will be the future there? What will those 40 seconds with each patient equate to?
So I saw this quote a while back that I think is critical to where we're at right now. Henry Ford said it many years ago. If people had asked me to what they needed, they would say faster horses. We have gotten around that now, is that we're not going after faster horses. We're actually taking a deviation. And we've heard transformation of healthcare for many years. We're at the cusp. I really believe this. I've been in healthcare for 35 years. I really believe we're at the cusp of how do we start bringing this data in and saving the physician not only 40 seconds, but now making it that here's some ideas that you might want to think about or diagnostics that could be beneficial, starting to involve other of their partners to be able to look at these records. We're changing the whole system and trying to make it more healthcare. Because currently we don't have as strong of a system, data-driven healthcare. That's where we're moving to. So I know lots of people throw transformation around, but this is one of the most transforming things I've seen in probably about two decades.
Wow, that's incredible words. Go
if I can that. Just also add, you know, it's this now, the reality of being able to look at an individual in a much more holistic manner, right? You can now look at not only the longitudinal history, you can eventually, with at this cusp of this evolution, this transformation, you can also look at now, how can we bring in environmental data? How can we understand somebody more holistically, right? Not just your genomic information, but your proteomics, your metabolomics. Are you allergic to pollen? What's it, you know, like really understanding a person at an individual N of one level. And I think that's where we're moving towards, right? And I think that's going to bring us to being more proactive into well care as opposed to being reactive for sick care.
And what do you think the upshot is for the patients themselves?
So I think the patients are going to get, one, a more personalized, as you just said, a personalized visit. So when I walk in, I don't want to hear, what's the best thing for a man over 60? I want to know what's the best thing for me, based on my exercise schedule, things I've had happen in the past. So now it's personalizing your healthcare, which is a whole different approach. We used to use it based on scientific evidence and medical data, saying a group of people, what, 6 million, 10 million people, this is what is best for them. Not looking at outliers. So now we could start looking for anomalies in there and correcting for that before it becomes a problem. So for the patient, right away it's personalizing. And then it's starting to bring in all this information to make it much richer. You know, it's almost like if even if we set up our LinkedIn accounts and all we put was our name and maybe our phone number, it's like, that doesn't tell me anything about you. But if he's now filled out the whole LinkedIn, you're like, oh, I know what this person, I know what their education is, I know. And see how we do it everywhere else. We just haven't applied it to healthcare because it's such a very difficult system with a lot of factors coming to play. So that's why we've been so fortunate working with Google, is that our understanding of healthcare and all the different databases that we have to deal with, and how do you overlay that? At the same time, talking to the providers to say, what do you need? If we make it so they have to do 10 more clicks or something, it's going to be very difficult to. So we have to work within them to get it within the clinical workflow.
Excellent, I love it. Adding AI to make healthcare more personal, absolutely.
Isn't that a strange
thing to say? Bring in the robots. Well, Shweta and Ron, thank you both so much for coming on theCUBE. A great conversation.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
And thank you for tuning into this segment of theCUBE's coverage of HIMSS 2025. I'm Rebecca Knight. Stay tuned for more of theCUBE.